नाक कटवा दी ग्रुप किया
दादा
It is his birthday. Happy birthday, Dada. Happy birthday, Saurav Ganguly. For that, you have to do this now. That's what Dada does.
Hey, no, I'm doing what Dada also does.
Which is what? Not showing up on time.
One. And two, making a comeback just when you write me off.
True.
Nice. There you are. Well done. Well done, boys. Shabash.
I got to tell you, the biggest eye-opener for me in the last few years has been just the quantum of pure love, not respect. Everybody has respect for a captain. The pure love that the younger players of his team back then have for him even now. So, you know, the thing is that it's very easy when someone's a captain and someone is captain and gives you a chance and you go, oh, he's a great captain, because we're still playing, right? And it's India, you've got to be politically correct. But when you've all retired and when the person is retired, you've retired, there is no skin in the game. There is no mutually beneficial scratchback situation. The kind of love that when you talk to Zach, Ashu, Harbhajan, UV, that entire gang of youngsters at that time, you realize the importance of Saurav Ganguly for changing the course of Indian cricket and the mindset of players.
Absolutely. Well said, Gaurav. I think I just like to add one more point, which many people mention, is that, you know, recognizing talent is something Saurav Ganguly had. But backing the talent is something which many captains, they get a little scared. And that's why they always say that great spinners come only when you have great captains, because there's a time that, you know, the spinner doesn't bowl the ball, but the captain will stick to this thing. And therefore, Harbhajan Singh, or for that matter, Veeru, will always talk about the fact that Dada ko talent dikhta hai, magar Dada talent ko back karta hai. Aur wo backing is a very, very high risk game when it comes to being the captain of India. Because how much are you going to back? And I think one of the key strengths of Saurav Ganguly was that he saw that and he backed people even when they were not playing well, because he knew that they would one day shine for India. I think these are the two key things which Gaurav mentioned to some extent, and Jatin, I'm sure, will add his points.
No, again, similar people who we've heard stories from, Ashu, Bhajji and all. And I think one of the reasons that love comes through, and I think it will continue coming through, is the transparency that Dada maintained with all these players. I mean, we always talk about selectors need to be transparent. I've heard stories from Bhajji, Ashu, that if you were not playing, you could walk into his room at 11:30, knock on the door and reason with him, boss, why am I not playing? You could use whatever language you wanted. And by the end of it, he would tell you where he's coming from. And there was no love lost. So he was the captain, the senior guy, but any and everyone had that access to him. You know, today we talk a lot about MSD, always has his door open. He talks to youngsters, spends time with him. I think, again, starting point was perhaps Dada, where these youngsters could speak to him like an elder brother. Bhai, kyun nahi khila raha mere ko? And he would never make that an issue that aapne mere se aake aise baat kaise kari. And I think that speaks volumes of the comfort that he gave to all these players who went on to become great. So again, yeah, common thread again being how he backed them and just small ways of doing it differently maybe.
On a lighter note, what I liked about Saurav Ganguly was Saurav Ganguly did not like running between the wickets. And as a cricketer, I really appreciate that, because I also wanted to be that. So I remember I used to do a joke years back, you know, if I've gone to Saurav Ganguly's house, he has hundreds of crores of property, 20 cars and so on and so forth. If I had that kind of money, even I won't ever run. So, because he is Maharaja, so why should Maharajas do all the work?
If you can pierce the offside like he did, you deserve not to run. You can take
exactly,
it.
Exactly. And that too on the... And coming from West Bengal, being God on the left side is a natural progression.
Nice one. Jatin, he said just one last story about him that he only told me. He's about this. When you just said that he would explain, Jatin said he would explain to youngsters why you're not picked. So Dada only told me this. He said that he says the thing is that I wanted players who could go for the win, not players who went for the draw. So this is how risk averse you know, usually people in India are, but he never was. He always courted that risk, and he wanted, because, you know, higher the risk, higher the reward. So what he would say is that on days which are not yours, the other team will kill you, right? But on days which are yours, you should be able to go on to the kill, right? You should press down on the jugular. So I can only do that if the players have that mindset as well. And his job was to enable them in saying, go for the win. Gadbad ho gaya, main hoon tumhare piche. I'm the backstop, right? But you have to. Don't play for your position. Don't play for your numbers. Don't play safe. Just go for it. So he said that I always like to back players who had that hunger in them. And he says, whenever I knew with Ashish Nehra, whenever I announced an 11, and if Nehra was not in the team, the night before, I knew I would announce the team. And if Nehra's not there, as soon as we spread the team, told the news to the team, I would call room service and order two chais, because I knew that in 5 minutes, Ashish Nehra will be at my door. So, no. Dada, क्या मेरे को खिला नहीं रहे, मैं तो इतना कर रहा हूँ, मेरी 145 में बॉल जा रही है, कल कहते तो मैंने सोच भी लिया इसको ऐसे आउट करूंगा, ये करूंगा. He says, I would let him talk, let him have the chai, and I'd say, Ashu, I back you, कल मेरा ये प्लान है, पर तू खेलेगा, तू मेरे प्लान में है, अगले मैच में नहीं तो उसके बाद वाले मैच में तू खेलेगा. कहता है, he would finish his chai, he would finish his rant, and then he would leave. So it was about how he managed individual players.
GK, no. Wait, just finishing chai and Mr. Nehra won't leave.
Yeah.
Order another one. One more chat. Then order one more. You know,
till it's time for Dada to pad up in the morning.
Exactly. Like, main to khel nahi raha, ab aap bhi aise hi chale jao.
But yaar, ek mere ko last point quickly main batata hu ki ek bahut log bolte hain Sourav Ganguly ke bare mein. I think he is responsible for the freedom movement of Indian cricket. When I say that, you know, taking on the the Britishers, or for that matter, people outside of your country, the confidence that Dada gave, and he actually communicated that to the players, that yaar, Goro ko marna koi mushkil baat nahi hai, and don't give them that kind of importance. You have to understand, this is a pre-IPL world, when we go and we play against the mighty Australians, you automatically see Glenn McGrath, Shane Warne, you're scared, because even as an Indian, and I'm not talking of Tendulkar, Dravids, but the rest of the players. And Dada used to say, dhyan mat de, terko jo aata hai wo kar. So the importance of the opposition was completely devalued when Sourav was there, and that's why coming late to Steve Waugh's toss, I think, is the most pivotal moment of Indian cricket.
You know what he says, right? Though it's amazing. He's like, but you know, actually, what happened is that wo ek main last player na hamesha rakhta tha thoda to make a change and all. So when I last player ka change kiya, and then they said, "Arey toss ho gaya," and realized I couldn't find my jacket. So then someone ran to get my jacket. I was like, "Dada, that's a great story." This is what we told Steve later, right? He said, "No, it's the truth." And all. I loved it.
Sourav Ganguly once forgot his bat when he went into the crease to bat, because Lakshman was in the loo. He was having a shower. And everybody said, Ganguly, you need to go into bat. Ganguly said, no, I'm not going. Let Lakshman go. There was this chaos happening. Finally, Sourav agreed. Everybody put pads and gloves into Sourav's hands and this thing. And he walked to the ground without a bat. And then he turned back and they gave him the bat. That's one funny side of Ganguly.
Bhai, hand cricket bhi to khele hum sab life mein. Yaad hai?
True. Just last weekend, we were doing the show and we had Nasir Hussain joining in. And I'm sure you might have read the statement. He said, absolutely used to hate Ganguly when we were playing cricket. Because not just he made Nasir Hussain wait. And he actually gave a very nice thing. He's like, before Sourav was the captain, you knew the Indian team was a very good team. You know, they could compete. But Sourav looked for players who were like him, who were going to be fighters. He like, so even then, the team would meet you in the morning, say, good morning, Nasir. And you're like, oh, they're a good bunch of boys. But then you'd see them on the field. And this was a different team than what he had faced between, say, 96 to 2000. So he's like, and that's just what you guys were saying, right? He identified his own inner hunger and that fire in players, and then just went all in backing them.
Yeah, man. No quarter asked, none given. That was the kind of guy he was.
And Mithun Manas, the other day, Mithun Manas, sorry, Jatin, you want to say?
I was just saying, not to forget when Dada became the captain, right? This is not to... We always talk about Graham Smith's story being the young captain, but Dada became the captain when I think Indian cricket was at its all-time lows. So to handle it around that period, after that scandal and all of it, for someone who's 4 years into his test career and then leave a legacy, I think this is also incredible, yeah?
True. You know, Mithun Manas told me something very interesting last week when I asked him what is... on Twitter, he replied. He said the difference between Sourav Ganguly and MS Dhoni was Dada looked for players who had fire. MS Dhoni looks for players who can soak pressure. I thought it was a very interesting way of kind of, you know, take two insights of two different successful captains of India.
Nice.
You know, it's very strange. I don't know if this resonates with you guys at all. Like, I mean, I know this whole thing of cricket being a religion, blah, 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 is overdone. But I like, for me, somebody who's grown up in...
Is there a better spot for Wi-Fi somewhere?
This is for you, Saurabh.
Jatin is looking for his own god right now, which is Wi-Fi, as soon as I said religion.
Now, just check on the left side, you'll find God there.
So, I don't know if this resonates with you guys, but it's
Let
like,
me try that one.
I don't think he realizes he's not on mute.
Yeah, I don't think so. Let him keep going and suffering.